island's tourism sector has taken another blow by the recent incident. Articles have been circulating over the social media and on newspapers in the Caribbean and the UK. Lon Theophilus says with rampant speculation, it is important that there is no silence on such matters. Mr. Theophilus says that the government cannot remain silent on the matter.
It is a terrible concern, and you must appreciate that all incidents, whilst people may come up with the excuse that yes, heinous crimes occur in almost every destination around the world, but at the same time it doesn't make it any more acceptable within ours. And I sincerely believe that St. Lucian people now need to take stock.
Mr. Theophilus highlights matters as these always carry implications for the island's vital tourism sector.
Vital industries like tourism here, and we intend to rely on it to generate revenue, that we need to protect it. So we can't have fools going around the place robbing people, snatching chains and doing things not just to the tourists, but things that affect the daily lives of our people. So we have to get serious.
Just this week, police stated that they still cannot definitively identify the burnt body recovered as Oliver Gobat. At a press conference summoned Wednesday, police said they are relying on external forensic expertise to make a conclusive identification of the remains. For the DBS News World, Jason Hullingseed reporting.